me and Willie Bank been around long enough that we both shook Sinatra's hand. And there's a code amongst guys that shook Sinatra's hand.
I always call him Francis. He always called me Kenneth. That's what it was.
Because I was a huge fan of Sinatra's, and I still am a huge fan of Frank's. I miss him a lot.
And it's just not easy, even now, you know, knowing that he's not here. He's going to walk in and say, what's going on? Which was his key line to me, you know.
So I would pick him up and we'd drive to a restaurant and he'd be sitting next to me in a car, we'd be driving. And in the back of my mind, I'd think, Frank Sinatra's sitting right there.
You know? I called him Cheech, you know, because he used to call me Patsy.
In the time since the passing of Francis Albert Sinatra, his already sizable legend has continued to grow. And here in the desert, Sinatra's part-time home, the legend is as big as ever.
He adores the theater, however doesn't get there late.
And even though millions of people all over the world had encounters with old Blue Eyes, it's a short list of people who actually knew the man. Producer Jerry Weintraub, golfer Ken Venturi, musician Pat Rizzo, singer Frankie Randall, and of course, Frank Sinatra Jr. These are just a few of the men left who could call Frank Sinatra a friend.
I just thought the world of him. I just think about him all the time and the times we were together. And no one was more generous, charity-wise and things.
Of course, I moved here because of Frank Sinatra. And he came in to see me and he said, why don't you move to Palm Springs? I said, get out of here. I said, Palm Springs, you people are just waiting to die there. He said, no, he said, come. He says, we have a great time. And every night it was a party at his house.
We'd all be at Frank's house for parties. When I started to get to know Frank and his ups and downs and how his personality worked with people and away from people.
But friends or not, if you worked with Frank Sinatra, he could be tough.
What was it like? Working for your
father? Oh, it was a learning experience. Most of what I learned was how to duck. but that was, it was a very, very big learning experience.
And I would stand backstage with him and he'd be fixing his tie in the mirror and checking the handkerchief. And when the clock, if there was an 8 o'clock show, when the second hand got to 12, he wanted to hear the timpani roll to start the show.
And I felt that there was a tap on my shoulder, and I turned around, and it was Sinatra. And he said to me, Jerry, look, it's 8:03. And I said, yeah. He said, well, we're supposed to start at 8 o'clock. Let's go.
I have people come up to me sometimes and say, can I shake the hand that shook the hand of Frank Sinatra, you know?
You shook Sinatra's hand. You should know better, Willie.